Hey guys, Street Smart Joker here with another exciting video, and again I have a deluxe edition with me. Last time I created a deluxe edition around Flash Rebirth, and this time I have the super awesome Batman Year One deluxe edition, as you can see, by Frank Miller, David Mazzucchelli and Richmond Lewis. I got it for a good price. I actually wanted to buy the normal trade paperback. I was lucky enough to find this in the deluxe edition and I grabbed it with both my hands. Removing the dust jacket here and showing you the binding. So it's a cover splash kind of an image, as you can see. Really nice dust jacket and a really nice binding. So going into the actual book, very, very famous book. It's a must have. I believe that everyone would have told you from the Batman mythos. The name goes, this is the first year of Batman returning to Bruce Wayne, returning to Gotham, and how he builds up to become the Batman we know him to be is the entire storyline. Some brilliant artwork. This was published 50 years back, right? I think it's almost 50 years back since this book was published. Not sure exactly, but each of the chapters has a very good introduction, let's say, and gives it in a simple lines. Chapter one, who I am, how I came to be, right? Another interesting lines are, he will become the greatest crime fighter the world has ever known. It won't be easy. Right? Some of this good character descriptions, character build-up. The build-up of Commissioner Gordon is very interesting in this book. So, both of them, Gordon is coming to the city to be part of the police force for the first time. Bruce is returning to start his journey to becoming the Batman. Right? These are some of the stories that is covered in this panel. The great part of this book is even though the artwork is a reminder of the original artwork, the feel to the pages is really good, right? As you can see the early stages of Catwoman, Selina Kyle here, right? You are even shown Holly here, who is her close mate, and how Bruce fights off some goons in the highway, and most of it is about how he gets thrashed. Throughout, right? Right? And then after that, he came to the realization that he needs to have a cover up, an alias. He cannot go out and fight crime as Bruce Wayne or using some mask. He needs to be something more. And that is when the bat appears in front of him. Very famous scene, this one. And then he decides to become the bat. Again, some few lines. He has trained and planned and waited for 18 years. He thinks he is ready. So this chapter 2, war is declared, right? It's a really, some of these lines are really cheesy. At the same time, it's really interesting to read. There is another one in which I think Gordon is having an affair with one of his associates. That's a different take on Gordon altogether. And slowly and surely you could see Batman, taking up more and power, more and more goons and villains within Gotham, right? And obviously in this storyline, the police is completely against him. They want to finish him off. They come and bomb the building in which he is in, and then the army moves in, right? That is where this story starts. They've got him cornered, they've got him outnumbered, they've got him trapped. They are in trouble. Chapter 3, Black Dawn. Right, and this is the story in which he has to fight off all the policemen who are inside the building. So, I know I'm taking a lot of your time, but I really wanted to show off the panels and the deluxe edition, how it looks, right? And how Commissioner Gordon, sorry, in this book, he's not the commissioner, he's just a lieutenant, I suppose. The next f is the next chapter, Friend Indeed. He's out to clean up a city that likes being dirty. He can't do it alone. That is where the Gordon and Bruce Wayne, alias Batman, has to come together to fight crime side by side in their own different ways, right? So I'll just rush through some of the other panels we have here, right? And this is the very famous story arc where Batman saves Commissioner Gordon's son, which is also there in the movie Dark Knight. But I think there it happens. Two-Face is the one who drops the kid, right? So that is the story. And then we have some afterword. The story ends up in a way that Commissioner Gordon has established himself, and they talk of the Joker. So I'll read it to you. As for me, well, there is a real panic on. Somebody's threatened to poison the Gotham Reservoir. Calls himself the Joker. I've got a friend coming who might be able to help. Should be here any minute. So he's waiting on top of the rooftop, and this is where the bat signal will be installed. Right, on the afterword, there are some black and white storyline of something. I think Dynamic Duo, Batman and Robin. I forgot exactly what it was, but some sketches and characterizations and stuff like that. Some good material which you can go through if you want to know more about how the year one came to be. These are the pages where which shows how the script was written, and based on that script, how the sketches were formed. All those things are in here, which gives you a clear idea of how this comic was thought after and how it came to be, right? So it's really good that the deluxe editions and the absolute editions carry this kind of information, right? I also seen the absolute edition for the same. I quite honestly, I thought deluxe edition was fine because it had all the story, it had all the details that you need to know about year one. Absolute edition is much, much more costly than the deluxe edition. Plus, the additional material they had in that absolute edition was actually the part where they had the original paper and the original way in which year one was published, or like almost 30, 40 years back, which I think we can do away with, right? So deluxe edition is what I picked up. I would love to know if you guys picked up the absolute edition and you found something else very interesting there. That's it. So thanks for watching. Keep subscribing, keep liking, keep the fire going on comic books and the love for comic books in India. Always here to help, always here to contribute. So, sayonara from Street Smart Joker. Bye bye.